Someone to watch over.
I was just getting you to say the words out of my mouth.
Imagine that.
Yeah, no, I'm serious. I was just going to say the same thing.
And why? Yes.
Just because it's such a beautiful song. It's
the lyrics, classic. Everything about it, yeah. Are incredible.
I mean, it's the epitome of the great American songbook. Yeah, it's like unbelievable. Absolutely.
I'm a little lamb who's lost in the wood. It's amazing.
Elton, what does this moment mean for you?
Where do you think you'd both be without each other?
Nowhere. We wouldn't be here, I know that. Talking to you guys.
Right here, Elton. Him first,
Elton, right here.
Down.
Elton, right over here. Elton, this way. Hello,
Mazer, if you don't mind.
There you go, guys.
Elton, where would you be without each other?
All right.
Well, it's just part and parcel of it. If you're successful, you have to give back. And that's my mantra when I got sober in 1990. And it's been my mantra ever since. And, you know, the two go hand in hand. If you get great success, then you have to offer something back.
Comment straight ahead of me, this way. Beautiful. Elton, this way.
That they can be played by anybody and sung by anybody. So that's a testament. We love so much different music. I think there's not a genre of music that we don't really like so much. And that's been the length and the longevity of our career has because the songs vary and the songs last because they cover different territories. Philadelphia Freedom is not like Burn Down the Mission. Daniel is not like Saturday Nights or Right for Fighting. There's a lot of different stuff.
Our palette is full of colors.
Yeah.
Thank you guys so much.
Okay.
Right. Thank you.
Thank you.
Come on, let's get
it.
There we go. Stand right here. Come on, hold on. And
probably Saturday Nights for Fighting. Is that, I don't know if I said it right.
Saturday Nights, all right?
Yeah, Saturday Nights.
I said one song.
Yeah, all right. My yellow.
So, could the...
This way again?
Right.
Miss Boris right here.
Yeah, yeah. That's what I'm saying.
Well, they've just been so supportive of my career since the jump. Elton John called me on the phone back in like 2016, and I was just starting out, and I thought it was a prank phone call. And the fact that it was him, it just shattered me. And so, I mean, I'll never be able to repay him, but doing something like this tonight and singing one of my favorite songs, I'm singing, I guess that's why they call it the blues. I just, you know, I love both of them so much. Bernie has come to every show I've had in LA, and his family is so lovely. So, yeah, it's wonderful being here tonight for them. I feel like this is certainly the longest partnership in songwriting history. It's amazing that they've been able to nurture it for many decades. But yeah, when you find a partner that you have chemistry with, lyrically, musically, and can grow through the years with one another, I mean, there is nothing more special. Even if it's just platonic friendship, I mean, that's sometimes even more important, and probably why they've, you know, been able to make such beautiful music for us this long.
What was interesting, and when I look back, is that I was really young, yet really connected, and I didn't know why, right? The eccentricity, the flamboyance, the fun, it was like, oh, that's queer. There was no language for it, but that's what it was. And eventually, that's what we all came to understand. Yeah, so that was my connection.
Yeah.
That was a big connection for me. Dreams do come true. You know, you must believe in yourself. You must manifest it for yourself. Because everything you want can happen, for real. And it takes a lot of work. And it takes a lot of focus. You gotta focus, and you have to do the work. And when those two things come together, it is magical. Tonight is magical.
The legacy of the Gershwin is the Gershwins and the Gershwin Prize is so important to watch because it's the highest honor in songwriting. And I really like watching these wizards, these sorcerers, of the craft be honored in the way that they are honored with the Gershwin Prize. It really is truly the highest honor. I watched Elton and Bernie speak last night, and their speeches were just grace personified, and you could tell that they understood the gravity of the accolade. Honestly, man, it's really surreal. This is not a situation I ever thought that I would find myself in, especially performing the songs I'm performing tonight, which you'll see when I do it. It's bringing me back to a time in my life when I really needed Elton and Bernie. I needed their words, and I needed them to help sculpt my worldview and show me the future I could be a part of. And so, it's going to be heavy for me tonight, but I'm so proud of them. The Gershwin Prize is the highest honor in songwriting, and it's really beautiful to see them honored in such a profound way for their craft. I don't know that there's ever been anybody better.
Oh, now you really put me on the spot.
Or two or five.
Yeah, okay, well, I'll give you Rocket Man. I'll give you Your Song. I'll give you Daniel. I'll give you the whole catalogue, to be quite honest with you. Because it's very hard to find one song out of that whole catalogue that isn't as good as the next. Each one of them is phenomenal, you know. And I get to sing one tonight, so I'm very excited about it.
Hey, Garth.
Hey, Garth.
Right there, Garth. Oh, it's good to see you. Oh, yeah, both of you. Garth, right here, the two of you.
Mr. Ewan, right here, please.
Thank you very much. And right over here.